Hi folks, this is David Tim Kwan here, and today I want to talk about social work for the homeless. I think I've talked about this in a previous video before, but this is kind of one of my projects that I've done. It's a Pinterest website. It's kind of an interesting thing to have this kind of thing on a Pinterest, but it's not uncommon. It's not unheard of, actually. I've seen many different kind of nonprofit organizations post informative graphics and outreach kind of things on Pinterest. Pinterest is not usually a space for things like nonprofit causes, human rights, social justice, things like that. But they are on there. A lot of organizations use it, and I could see why. It's an amazing website to kind of just be like, here are some amazing graphics and pictures that really pull you in, and it links you to more detailed blogs and articles and understanding and research that you can actually, you know, to engage with. It's an amazing idea. And my last semester, I was assigned for one of my classes to kind of make a social media project. And my passion has for a long time now been social work for the homeless. And so I wanted to utilize that kind of passion and create a social media project, and that's kind of what's happening. And so I am the curator, pretty much the owner, I suppose, of that Pinterest website. It's still very small. It's not known by many people, but it's gaining traction, which is really cool. When I first started it, I was just kind of curating and pinning, finding stuff on here, and I was like, oh, I like this stuff. Let's get a picture and let's post it and just link it. And kind of write a summary and distribute them there and kind of direct people to there if they find it somehow. And there are other pinners too, like there are a lot of great organizations that post graphics and on Pinterest. So I was like, that's cool, and Pinterest allows you to pin their stuff. So kind of taking their work, and it's kind of like retweeting or reblogging or sharing on Facebook, where you can kind of share other people's work and just boom, like just spread the message across, spread the word around on the website. So a lot of that was done, but it also did feel like where is my original voice in this? So a lot of the things that I posted up there, it's related. It's very helpful for any social worker who is passionate about serving the homeless people and supporting them, and or if they have a goal, kind of anti-poverty lens or eliminating or preventing homelessness, if that's kind of one of their objectives that they have as social workers, a lot of what I pinned is great. But then, you know, I start to think, well, what about, like, a lot of the voices on these pins are not social workers themselves particularly. So, and I'm a social work student, but even so, my voice would be a social worker's voice. And that's why I started thinking, like, I need to add more original content on here, stuff that I write, stuff that other social workers write. That's kind of, I need to do more searching of other social workers that I can kind of pull into. That's kind of been my inspiration of kind of like writing this blog post, that this blog actually got the most views I've ever gotten, I think, on my blog site. So that's pretty awesome in a lot of ways. But I feel like this was kind of a long time coming to write this kind of thing. So I wanted to share on this video kind of briefly about what I wrote. I'm not going to read the entire thing, but just I'll have it linked in the video description, just talking about this concept. And I do plan, I haven't really done too much with my Pinterest website, adding my original voice. I do want to add a lot more. I want to have this blog post that I particularly done in the beginning is called Why Social Work for the Homeless. But I want to address deeply as I go on further. I need to write more stuff. Future blog posts will probably be like, how social work for the homeless. So I think the why is pretty obvious. But even so, I think I wrote the why because there's a lot of misconceptions about what social work for the homeless means. What the homeless means. The concept of homelessness, I think, is something that gets thrown around, but it's very easily misunderstood or misconceived in a lot of ways. That's why I wrote this. But there's so many things I want to address personally at someone whose passion is this social work for the homeless. So my plan is for my life to be that social work for the homeless. I think it's unfortunate that has to be my life, because if there was no homelessness, that wouldn't even be a thing. It would be more like, well, it could still be social work for the homeless in that I'm working to prevent it. I'm working to support those who are about to be homeless, providing services to those who are formerly homeless. It could still be that, but it's less about this instance of like, there are so many homeless people out here, we need to support them and kind of address this issue. There would be much less of that. It's unfortunate that has to be my life. But that's kind of my life passion, is those social work for these five words, social work for the homeless. That's my life in a nutshell, or plan to be. Anyway, what I kind of wrote is the blog post is why social work for the homeless. Of course, I mentioned the NASW, which is the National Association of Social Workers. Social workers in the United States of America, we abide by this. The code of ethics that this organization wrote. And in the preamble of the code of ethics, it states the primary mission of the social work profession is to enhance human well-being and help meet the basic human needs of all people, with particular attention to the needs and empowerment of people who are vulnerable, oppressed, and living in poverty. That's the mission statement about social justice. Social justice would be defined by NASW as social and political equality of opportunity and resources for all, especially the disadvantaged. That's social justice definition. Whatever definition of social justice you have, that's I'm going by the NASW definition of social justice in this video as a social work student. Anyway, that's not the important point. The important point is that I make it is kind of the what I want to do, kind of just briefly talk about. It's a very short blog post considering kind of the other stuff I write. I know I talk a lot on videos. I also write. When I get to writing, it just kind of goes way too long, way too long. But this preconcept, you know, when I say I met a homeless person, you know, who are you thinking of right now? You know, and I think the public image of homelessness has somehow become this old person, usually men, but sometimes women too. Maybe you're thinking of a woman, but in dirty clothes, kind of acting a little bit fidgety or something. Maybe has a cardboard sign up or has a shopping cart just stacked full of their clothes and their belongings on the streets, smelling really badly. That might be an image of homelessness that you have. I think that's a very stereotypical public image, because when you go about your day-to-day lives, you're not going to notice homeless people unless they're like that, whereas like it's visibly homeless. But unfortunately, majority of the homeless population are not that. That's not the accurate image of homelessness. So that's why in my blog post I have this picture of pretty much just elementary school students in a classroom. This picture is not necessarily, I got it from, you know, Google Images. It's just a picture of students in a public school. That's all it is. But my point is that is actually a more accurate image of homelessness. Majority of homeless people in America are children in public schools. So that's kind of the most interesting aspect of homelessness is that most homeless people are families with children, and they're not necessarily on the streets. Actually, almost none are just out in the streets for you to be like, hey, give us money. I mean, they do that sometimes. They do we call it panhandling in New York City for whatever reason, but they do that. But a lot of times they sleep not on the streets, in their cars, in motels, in shelters, in churches, in other kind of uncles' homes and friends' homes for like one night, doubled up. These are the kind of situations that homeless people are in. So that's kind of why I wanted to kind of bring that up. You know, like when we think of homeless people, the image that you have of a person on the street with a cardboard sign, sure, you'll meet them. And we give so much attention in public messaging about them. But majority of homeless people, that's like the people out in the streets with cardboard signs, that's like what? Pretty much like 9% or 10% of the entire homeless population. And if you talk, we're talking about New York City, where I'm at, it's not even 9%. It's you know, we have what the record high number of homeless people in shelters. We have 58,000 people in shelters right now, and of those 58,000, that's 58,000, and then the other street homeless people out on the streets in the subway system, people you see on the streets holding cardboard signs, all smelly and dirty. They are actually about, I think the estimate currently is I'm gonna just broadly estimate. I'm not gonna get into the more accurate estimate, but it's about 3,000 people. So 3,000 street homeless and 58,000 non-street homeless. You see, the percentage-wise, majority of homeless people are not street homeless. So that's kind of the thing that I want to also address. But you know, they also mentioned very briefly that many homeless people, they have jobs, at least one job. That's 20% of the homeless population have at least one in five homeless people. Homeless population have at least one job. They have jobs and they still can't afford a home. Now, the facts and the faces of homelessness, that's kind of addressed more in detail in many articles and many blogs and also in my Pinterest page and things like that. I don't go too much into that in my blog about why social work for the homeless. So the rhetoric that I have, my reasoning is simply that in a lot of ways, social workers already do social work for the homeless, whether that's their passion or their interest or not. Just because whether you're in, you know, you're a social worker in a school who really don't really know much about homelessness, you might be a social worker at a clinic whose primary job is to kind of meet with clients with diagnosed with mental health issues and kind of give them counseling, group therapy, refer them. You might be working at a settlement house as a social worker. You might be working at a for-profit corporation giving a consultation advice about how their business can be more ethical. There are those social workers out there. You might be a state senator, which we actually have a senator social worker. I forget the name. I think it's Barbara Mikulski, I think. But you know, in any kind of fashion of social worker, even private therapist, whatever, you're likely to encounter a homeless client, somebody who's homeless that you have to serve. And so we do social work for the homeless just because our mission statement is simply that we work for the disadvantaged, the most oppressed, the most voiceless. So we end up doing it kind of anyway. So like, that's kind of the rhetorical question I asked in the blog is, aren't we doing social work for the homeless anyway? And in a sense, we do, whether knowingly or not knowingly. It is kind of the part of the work that we do. Whether we do it right is a whole another discussion. Maybe another blog post altogether. Like, are we as social workers succeeding in being social workers for the homeless or social worker for the poor? That's a very loaded topic altogether, and I think many people will have different opinions on that. I'm not going to interject my opinion on that in this video, but generally speaking, we are all kind of doing, all social workers are kind of, most social workers, you know, I kind of do that, doing that. Because, you know, one thing that really moves me personally, and this is probably another blog post in itself, because I don't mention my personal motive in this particular blog post. What moves me about homelessness is that it's so wide-reaching to all sorts of issues. In my Pinterest page, there is a board for related issues. And really, like, you can kind of fit almost any social work topic on there. The issue of homophobia, the issue of anti-black racism, the issue of, you know, the corrupt criminal justice system, the issue of affordable housing being a losing fight, and all the kind of interesting related mental health of substance abuse, all these other things that are thought of as non-homeless issues are actually very related to social work for the homeless. So that's kind of the reason I put that board up there. It's a wide-reaching thing. Everything that I've learned in social work, education, and training is very, very powerful to use to serve the homeless and to use to prevent homelessness in our communities. And I want to skip a lot of the... So in my blog post, there's also this whole thing about, you know, who are the homeless. Pretty much everyone can be. Anyone can be homeless. It's kind of the message that I put. But I want to just, to hoot my own horn, say what I wrote here. You know, they might have physical disabilities and physical injuries, and they might not. So I'm talking about the homeless. And they usually have other identities they prefer to be known as. So by this I mean, we call them homeless. That's kind of their identity, right? But they also usually, almost always, have other identities they themselves would prefer to be known as. Examples, as veterans, as history teachers, as mothers, as fathers, as writers, as workers, as survivors, as human beings who are just like you and me, as valuable and contributing members of society who, despite of and because of their current difficulties, are still alive and kicking. So that I thought was to kind of bring that homeless people are human beings, but also that they have so many strengths and so many identities about them that's not just about them being homeless in a lot of ways. And I think that kind of messaging can be very hard to overlook, especially us social workers who are very tuned into, like, what are the issues? How can we address these issues? Well, you know, what we it's good to, like, not sometimes think about the issues, but think about the human being that you're meeting right there. So that's kind of what I say. I'll read the last paragraph and end the video there because it's already such a long video. I end the blog post saying this. Helping these people is not about giving them homes. So yes, Housing First is very effective. So it's not about giving them homes and then saying that homelessness is solved. That helps, but you know, you can't just end it at that. On the other hand, it's definitely not about cutting all benefits and services to them and saying that it's their fault that they're poor and homeless. It's looking at the mirror and realizing every day that homelessness is us. A society that allows someone to sleep in the streets, doubled up in shelters, especially a five-year-old someone, that's us. And it doesn't have to be. Anyone can become poor, and anyone can become homeless. When we look in the mirror, that possibility should be very clear to us. And that's what Social Work for the Homeless is all about. To work towards a society that makes us proud to be us.